Thank you, guys. It's time for the last comedian of the night. He was born in Montreal, Quebec. He now lives in Toronto, Ontario. Please welcome Massimo.
Hi, my name is Massimo. I've been doing comedy for 11 years, and I like the Bruds. I wanted to become a stand-up comic because, I don't know, it just always seemed like a fun job. You get to work at night for, you know, maybe an hour, you know, a night, and not even like the full hour, maybe 30 minutes, 45 tops. You get to meet ladies, you know what I mean? You get to meet girls, take them home. How would I describe my stand-up style? I think misunderstood, you know what I mean? People just see like a dirty, dirty pig, but inside is a sensitive little boy. I am gonna win this competition because I've never won anything in my life. I've been pretty much living like at like par, just like been like not a loser, but like just a little above loser. So I think this is like my time to like at least have something that my parents don't want to like, you know, kill themselves or feel shame about me. If I could say one thing to our contestants, it would be don't show up tonight because I don't do well with competition.
Hey, what's happening? What's
yeah? No, I know, eh? Was... No, I know. I'm incredibly handsome. No, I am. No, listen. I don't want you to think I'm one of those like super conceited guys, because I'm not. But let's face it, I'm easy on the ice. No. I see a lady checking me out. Yeah, what's up, man? Nice, wicked. That's all I got, really. That's all. No, listen to me. Listen, yes, sir. Yes, that is the point I'm making. Listen, some comedians, they're like good writers and shit. You know what I mean? And then some of us, we just have a nice smile, really. You know what I mean? That's what God gave me, and that's what I work with. You know what I mean? Because sometimes God is like really busy, and he doesn't have time. To make everybody special and unique. You know what I mean? Sometimes God has like a big rush order of babies, right? And he's just pounding them out. There's like that conveyor belt that's coming through, right? And he just like, he gets to a baby, gets stuck. He's like, okay, he's not good with his hands. He's not exactly cure cancer. No, fucking nice smile next. Big tits, let's go, keep them coming. I got a million of these, right? Because remember the girl in high school with the big titties? She wasn't good with math, she wasn't. And. Well, listen, some of you laughed, some of you didn't. Some of you ladies, probably very angry with me for what I just said. Shouldn't be angry with me. It's God's. Actually, you shouldn't be angry with God, you know what I mean? God has a lot of shit to do. Everybody's always angry with God. My life is not where I want to be, right? God has a lot to, he has to create like a world, right? And he can't just like take it, throw up. He has to like put some fucking shit in it, like fucking like rivers, and, like trees, mountains, fucking snow. You know how many fucking snowflakes God has to make? The whole night he's up. These fucking people with the fucking snowflakes all the time. Make it snow. Ooh, and every snowflake's unique. Every snowflake, they never fuck at all. There's your snow, you fucking monkeys. I'm saying we should ease up on the guy. He's got a lot on his fucking plate, you know what I mean? It's not easy being the CEO of life, you know what I mean? He's a lot to do. He's creating fucking universes and planets. He's a single dad. It's not easy. Boom! Another one in the bank. I don't have a bank account, but fucking... As soon as I get one, that's going in the fucking bank. Because that's fucking gold. Titties. I'm sorry, I have ADD. I love titties. I'm Italian. I know y'all look at me like, yeah, dude, we know. Like most Italian men, everything I do in my life is for the ladies. Like I got into comedy for the ladies. Because I hear that the ladies like a funny guy.
Exactly. Really bad career choice on my part. If I should have chosen anything in like performance, I should have chose like music, right? Because musicians, those are the guys getting tail after the show. Do you know what I mean? Because they're all like, because musicians are all sensitive, and they're all broken up inside, and women see that shit and they just eat it up. Like I am also sensitive and broken up inside, but unfortunately for me, my pain is not accompanied by the wonderful harmony of music, right? You know what I mean? And women see this shit and they just eat it up. There's like nothing to, like, I'm just saying, like, it'd be cool one night if some girl came home with me, had sex with me just because I told some fucking cock joke on stage. You know what I mean? Or even not even have sex with me. Maybe, like, if a lady at the end of the show, maybe if I told, like, one joke and I did, like, my last joke and I'm like, thank you, good night. She got up and then she flashed her titties. You know what I mean? I'm just saying. Doesn't have to happen, but it'd be nice, right? Because these musicians, they're getting everything. They're getting everything. They could do no wrong. Musicians could write like a really stupid song with a really dumb lyric, and women love it because they're all on stage, like singing all like sensitive, I'm gonna put it in your hole. It doesn't matter what they say. It doesn't matter. Even bands I like Alice in Chains. Alice in Chains has got this song, Rooster, thank you for confirming that they exist. One person, the rest of you are gonna fucking love this. Alice in Chains got this song, Rooster, and a line of the song goes, yeah, they come to snuff the rooster. Yeah, yeah, yeah. What kind of farm snuffs a rooster? You know what I mean? Like, what kind of farm uses the term snuff the rooster? Like, what is this, like a mafia runs farm or something? Like, what's going on with the day-to-day business at this farm? I just imagine in my head, it's like, Joey. Listen. I got this little job I want you to do over here. Go out to the chicken coop and snuff the rooster, all right? I'm tired of this prick waking me up at the crack of dawn. And another thing, you tell that fucking henny hangs out with, I want my eggs tomorrow, all right? Not next week. Tomorrow, all right? The deal was an egg a day. Lately, she hasn't been producing. And every time I see this chick, it's always the same excuse. Pork, pork, pork this, and pork, pork, pork that, like I give a fuck. No more excuses. You tell her, I told you that if I don't get my eggs tomorrow, I'm sending her ass to KFC. Thank you very much. Good night. Massimo!
I went good. I liked it. You know what I mean? There was laughs and stuff. You know what I mean? Nobody flashed me their titties, but what are you going to do? That's life. That's my life, actually. I think the first joke about God worked really well. And then at the end, a joke about, you know, like Alice in Chains joke. Vote often and many times. And if I'm rich, I will totally give you money or something. Not with the 10 grand, that's not really a lot of money for one day to spend on drugs and shit. But other than that, vote, just vote. That's all I can say about voting.